The Uganda National Oil Company, UNOC, has successfully received its first shipment comprising 78 million liters of petrol and 65,000 tons of diesel at Kipevu Oil Terminal 2 in Mombasa. First to dock at daybreak today was a ship carrying 58,000 metric tons of petrol. This consignment will be discharged into the Kenya Pipeline Company infrastructure and transported to Kisumu, where it will be transferred to trucks for delivery to Uganda. Another ship carrying 65,000 metric tons of diesel is expected to dock at the same terminal at midnight. This development follows months of anticipation and extensive agreements with Kenyan authorities. UNOC's role as the sole importer of petroleum products was solidified by the passing of the Petroleum Supply Amendment Act 2023, which granted the company exclusive rights to import and supply all petroleum products into Uganda. This strategic move is expected to stabilize palm prices in the local market. Previously, oil marketing companies directly sourced petroleum products from Kenya. Monthly shipments are planned to meet Uganda's fuel demand, which currently stand at 7 million liters daily, with an expected annual growth rate of 7% to 9%. In May 2024, Uganda and Kenya signed key agreements, which paved the way for UNOC to utilize KPC facilities to import petroleum products into the country. With this new arrangement, all petroleum dealers in Uganda will now buy directly from UNOC, not Kenyan middlemen. This change is expected to create a more stable and predictable fuel supply chain, ultimately benefiting the Ugandan economy. Officials from the Uganda Civil Aviation Authority today appeared before the Committee on Commissions, Statutory Authorities and State Enterprises, COSASE, to respond to results from the Auditor General's Report 2023-2024. The committee, which was chaired by COSASE Vice Chairperson Alan Mayanja Sewunya, the Member of Parliament for Nakaseke Central, tasked UCAA officials to explain the flooding at the Entebbe International Airport, yet the government borrowed money to refurbish it.
To explain the issue of floods, the drainage system is poor. Just go back to the contractor who designed it.
There is a systematic upgrade of our drainage system, which is ongoing.
And we are going to do it aligned to our development. We are doing that one of them.
The Director General, UCAA, Fred Bamwesije, blamed the ongoing construction works in Entebbe Municipality that has caused blockage of water channels leading to the flooding at the airport. The aviation officials also attributed the flooding to Entebbe receiving more rainfall compared to other parts of the country, which did not satisfy the legislators.
Entebbe International Airport received 30% of the total rain in the country. 30% only in Entebbe. So, this definitely had to overwhelm the system.
And it comes in a bigger volumes. But we are handling it, Honorable Chair.
I think you have professional engineers, if I think so. They should deal with the after effects before even starting.
The committee also raised the 116 billion shillings that was spent on salaries. Yet the Auditor General's report showed that some workers are non-existent and others are overpaid. Hurricane Beryl churned towards Jamaica today with forecasters warning of potentially deadly winds and storm surge after at least 7 people were killed and widespread destruction was reported across the southern eastern Caribbean. According to meteorologists, the powerful hurricane, which is rare so early in the Atlantic season, was expected to pass over Jamaica around midday as a life-threatening Category 4 storm. Beryl is the first storm since U.S. National Hurricane Center records began to reach the Category 4 level in June and the earliest to reach Category 5 in July. According to the NHC, a hurricane warning was in place for the island nation, which said drain and flash flooding were to be expected in addition to the life-threatening wind and high water levels. Across Jamaica, emergency response preparations were underway, with shelters stocking up on provisions, people safeguarding their homes, and boats being pulled from the water. According to the NHC, hurricane warnings were also issued in the Cayman Islands.
So like that going there.
What? which Barrow was expected to pass near or over on Wednesday night or early Thursday. In the Dominican Republic, massive waves were seen crashing ashore along Santo Domingo as the storm passed to the country's south. Barrow has already left a trail of death in its wake, with at least three people killed in Grenada, where the storm made landfall Monday, as well as one in St. Vincent and the Grenadines, and three in Venezuela. The World Meteorological Organization said Barrow sets an alarming precedent for what is expected to be very active hurricane season.